All right, so what I'm going to do this today is give you a tutorial on the SpoofX language workbench. And so let me tell you, so what I have a couple of slides to introduce, and then most of the tutorial will consist of live programming. All right, so I'm presenting, so I'm Ilko Visser, I'm a professor at TU Delft. But this is by no means, SpoofX is by no means something I've built by myself. It is a joint work with many, many people, students, postdocs, other people. So I should thank all of them. In particular, today I'm joined in the meeting by Jasper Denkers, Eduardo Amorim, and Henrik van Antwerpen. So Eduardo is a former PhD student. He graduated last year. And Jasper and Henrik are current PhD students. And they'll also, help me answer questions when I get stuck. All right, so what is SpoofX? So SpoofX is a language workbench, a tool for building programming languages. But it's really two things. So it's on one hand, it's a tool for implementing programming languages. It is open source and it is freely available. And it is used in education and research and industry. And it's real, and it requires a lot of engineering to maintain. And that's what my group works on. And we're really dedicated to support this as a tool, as a usable tool for people. But at the same time, it's also a research project. So it's a long-term research project and it's an incubator for all kinds of language engineering research. So it's a basis for implementation of all kinds of research on language engineering and evaluation of that in over 100 papers and the basis for over 100 papers. And really it's an imperfect approximation of my ideal language workbench, right? So what is my ideal language workbench that is basically summarized by this mission statement, which is language implementations from declarative language definitions. So as far as I'm concerned, you should be able to write a high level declarative specification and from that get an implementation of a language. That's the ideal, and the SpoofX is sort of our current approximation of that ideal, but doesn't mean we're there yet. So in more details, what are the goals? So in SpoofX, you're able to define languages, write language definitions. So define the syntax and semantics of programming languages. And specifically we're focusing or we're targeting domain specific programming languages, because for those, the sort of the cost of developing versus the benefit of use is, you cannot afford huge teams of programmers working on an implementation. We want specifications to be high level and understandable. So ideally what I would like is that a SpoofX definition can serve as the reference documentation, as the technical specification of a language. It should be executable. So we should be able to generate tools from them automatically. Declarative, so you should understand language definitions by their declarative semantics. No need to understand the underlying algorithms. Should be multipolar purpose, right? So a parser generator writes a parser from a grammar, but there are many more things you can generate from a grammar, as we'll see. And it should be correct construction. So implementations should be sound with respect to the declarative semantics. A brief history. So as I said, this is a long-term research project. I started working in this line of research in the 90s. So I did my dissertation on parsing and syntax definition. And in 97, I started on the Stratego transformation language, and together with SDF, for syntax definition, I built a command line suite of tools for language processing on C and Linux. Then I moved to Delft in 2006, and there we started working and we ported the SDF and Stratego tooling to Java. And at the same time, IBM came out with IMP, which was a framework for making Eclipse plugins, and that made it much easier to make such plugins than it was before. And we used that to build the first version of SpoofX. So basically, that was built on SDF and Stigo and a little language called ESV for editor services configurations. Then the next generation was SpoofX 2 or SpoofX Core. So the first SpoofX was really tied to Eclipse. It was hard to, you couldn't use it without Eclipse. In SpoofX Core, we disentangled the key elements of SpoofX from Eclipse. So SpoofX Core is just a Java library with bindings for Eclipse, IntelliJ, and command line, and other things as you may see fit. And it's built on the idea of meta languages that are targeted to particular aspects of language definition. And that's what I will be demonstrating in this tutorial. In the meantime, we've already started on the next generation of SpoofX, SpoofX 3, where we're really re-architecting the core, the guts of the language workbench, to be completely incremental and to support live language development based on the Pi build system. But that's not something I'll be demonstrating today. All right, so SpoofX is a research project, but it's also something we actually use. So we do research in language engineering using it, language prototyping. What I really should say here that the languages you will see, so the meta languages you'll see today are all bootstrapped. So we use SpoofX to build the meta languages that that are used in the language workbench. So that's, so you say, what can you use SpoofX for? It's, well, you can use it to build language workbenches. All right. So we use it in education. I teach a course on compiler construction in which students built a compiler for Mini Java. I'm currently seeing if to look for something new. So students, I teach a course on language engineering projects in which students built some new language, sort of free form. So I have projects on ADA and C and ChocoPy and FlowSpec this year. And ChocoPy is a language from Berkeley that I'm thinking about using as a basis for the compiler construction project. We use it in practice. So WebDiesel is a web programming language that we have developed using SpoofX, and that's built to build production web application, such as researcher.org, which is used for the PLDI program. And it's used in industry, for example, at Oracle Labs. And yes, they're bootstrapped indeed. And so at Oracle Labs and Canon, we're collaborating with them to build various DSLs.
Okay, well, maybe before you continue, there's another question from the panel. I think you can answer. How did you choose SpoofX for its name?
Oh, right. Yes, that's a good question. So I didn't. SpoofX, the name was, let's see. So as I was saying here, Stigo XT used to be a command line tool. I used Emacs to write SDF and Stigo, and we built everything on C and Linux. And then, one of my PhD students, Carl Kalleberg, a PhD student from Norway, he was interested in having an IDE for SDF and Stigo. And so he started porting the tooling underneath to Java, and he started building an Eclipse plugin. And he called that SpoofX, and that's a name he chose by basically Google engineering. So he was trying to find a name that was Google unique, that didn't have any hits in Google, so that's easy to find. And I think that is still successful, because I think if you search for SpoofX on Google, you find us. So otherwise, there's no meaning to the name that I know of. I mean, I remember discussing the name with Carl in the winter in Utrecht, and I said, it's just for an Eclipse plugin, right? I mean, who cares? And then I wasn't especially charmed with the name, but somehow it stuck. And yeah, there you go. All right. Are there limitations on the runtime of Spoofx defined languages? So Spoofx currently, so we translate, everything runs on the JVM. But you mean the runtime of Spoofx defined languages? So no, I mean, you can, in Spoofx, you can define a compiler for a language that generates, LVM or, right? And so that's fine. If that's what that was the question, right? Yes, good. All right, yeah. So key to Spoofx are meta languages for language definition. So we make DSLs, meta DSLs for different aspects of language definition. So we do syntax definition in SGF3, static semantics in statics, data flow analysis with FlowSpec, transformation with Stigo. We're working on dynamic semantic specification. We have a language called DinSem, and currently we're working on a new generation called Dynamics as a counterpart to statics, but that is really in an early stage. And we have editor service definition, ESV. So in general, so there's a collection of meta languages for language definition. All right, so, and I'm in this tutorial, I'm going to focus on the first two. Syntax definition and static semantics specifications. Right, so the goal is to demonstrate language development with Spoofx with a focus of the concept of two Spoofx meta languages using live programming. So I've been preparing slides for this tutorial for a long time, and I gave preparation talks in Instrumenta meetings with slides and so on. And then afterwards, my students said, well, and so I decided to switch and give a do live demonstrations, even though I have many nice slides. But, right, so part one, we're going to do syntax definition. Part two, static semantic specification. If you want, you can download the code on GitHub. I think I've posted the link in Slack. And afterwards, if you want to know more, there's these websites, there's documentation on the metaborg.org site. We do a course on compiler construction using Spoofx. And on my homepage, there's a whole bunch of publications about various aspects of Spoofx. If you want to know more, I mean, we have a Spoofx users channel on our Slack organization that we have guest users. So if you are interested, then send me an email and I'll invite you. And finally, if you're really into this, then join us. We have a whole bunch of open positions, and so we're hiring especially PhD students, but also two assistant professors. So if you're interested, contact us.